Morning, everybody. I welcome you all back for the special session, right? Today lecture, we will do the families. Basically, these families are important for BSc 2 according to the syllabus point. But they play an important role in OCT for BSc 1, 2 and 3 also. Besides that, for MSc 1, MSc 2, it plays an immense role in particularly in the IFS, Forest Services, then IAS, and the other competitive exam like staff selection, right? So today I will do the first family, that is Ranunculaceae, and subsequently the other families. So these lectures are not theoretical point of view, but they are the basically competitive point of view, how we can get the questions from these families. So I will ask you all to please learn it thoroughly. Just understand today, any problem, revert back to me. So learn it thoroughly, because a lot of questions will come in the competitive exams. So better understanding of families is much required, right? Stay indoors, stay safe. I will be back soon. Stay back. Good morning, everybody. I welcome you back. Today we are starting with the Brassicaceae family, Cruciferae. And because these families, they are very important through the competitive exams. So Brassicaceae I will take first, that is the Brassicaceae or Cruciferae. And we have one flower here, Brassica campestris. And the inflorescence is corymbous raceme. And the flower is E-bracteate, pedicellate, complete. Actinomorphic. It is complete. Actinomorphic. It is means it when it divided into they are equal parts. Bisexual. Hypogynous. Very important. Hypogynous. Cyclic and yellow. Right. So before moving above, I just want to tell you what is hypogynous condition. Hypogynous means hypo means below, and gynous means gynoecium. If sepals, petals, and stamens they are attached to the receptacle below the ovary. Means ovary superior and other parts which are endoparian means androecium, sepal, petals, they are inferior. And this is also, we will read again the families of Malvaceae and Anacardiaceae. Thalamus is convex or conical. And androparian is born below the level of ovary, which I told you. So ovary is superior and other parts are inferior. And the thalamus is not fused with the wall of ovary. So to explain it more, I will tell you, see, this is the thalamus, and these parts, they are joined below the ovary. So they all are inferior, and the ovary becomes superior, right? So this is the structure I am telling you, and this is the hypogynous. And the thalamus is convex or conical in shape, right? So in case of others like epigynous, and these parts they are above, see, right? And here the ovary is inferior and the other parts are superior, right? And thalamus is, you will see, flask shaped, and it is fused. See, fused. And then is the perigynous. In perigynous, the thalamus you will see cup shaped, disc shaped. They may be at the level of the ovary or above the ovary, but their point base is same. Point of origin is same. Right? They are cup shaped, saucer shaped. These are the perigynous type. So now I am coming back again to the detail, because calyx is 4 free polysepals, which are in two roles, outer role anterior posterior, and the two laterals they form the inner role, right? They are saccate with pouch like structure at the base to store nectar. Lanceolate, margin of sepal entire, apex, acute and they're inferior because by default they are hypogonous condition, they have to come in as inferior. See the structure. These are the sepals, and just I told you these sepals they are basically four free and polysepals in two roles, the outer role, anterior posterior, and two lateral inner role. Okay, these are the outer roles and these are the inner roles, right? And see, right, and then we are coming to the corolla. Corolla are also four free polypetalous, they are cruciform. See, cruciform, clawed, longer than sepals, right, spreading, wall width, estivation, and they are inferior. See, they are, these are sepals and they are longer than sepals. They are clawed. See, these are claws, then they have limbs. So this structure in which we have claws and limbs is called cruciform. Right? See, here also. Right? And these petals, I already told you, they are opposite. They are in form of claws and they are in the limbs. So these, I already told you, corolla, basically, they have the claw-like structure. And let's see. Clawed petals. Right? Now we are coming to the part of the androecium. So you see the androecium. See, so androecium is basically six polyandros tetradynamous, four longer stamens, they form anterior posterior pairs. See, four longer, they will form anterior and posterior, anterior posterior, 1, 2, 3, 4, and two. And these, they are arranged in inner role, and the two smaller lateral stamens, they form the outer role. These four will form the, this four. These four, they will form the inner, whereas the two, these laterals, they will form the outer role. And anthers, they are bisaffixed. See, they are bisaffixed. Right, they are bisaffixed, right, and dehiscence longitudinal, with longer they have extros and shorter intros. See, longer they are towards extros and shorter towards the intros, right? So they have the four dot green like nectar glands at the base of the outer and inner paired stamens. As we know, this is a hypogynous condition. It is inferior by default because the ovary is superior, right? So now we are coming to the ovary, that is the gynoecium. Gynoecium is bicarpellary, same carpus, superior ovary, unilocular, and becomes bilocular by the formation of a false septum. See, this is ovary, it is unilocular, but by the formation of this false septum, it becomes bilocular, and the placentation is parietal and style short, parietal with many ovules, style, see, style short, this style is short and stigma is bifid, and the fruit, very important, is silicua, silicua or silicula. Right, so the seed is non-endospermic. So now we are coming again to the this I already do silicua or silicula, and this is we have bisexual, actinomorphic, K2+2C4, right, which is volvate, and A2 plus 4, right? Androsium, I told you, androsium is tetradynamous, and the gynoecium, it is parietal placentation, it is superior because of the hypogynous condition. Now we are coming to the very important part, that is raceme. We have here is inflorescence, that is corymbous raceme, an unbranched peduncle, bear pedicillate flowers in acrobatal fashion, but longer pedicel of lower flower does not bring them to the upper one, right? So corium raceme, you will see, this is the raceme. We have a longer pedicel, but it does not bring to the same plane like we have in umbilical. Here it will come to the same plane, but here they, in spite of longer pedicels, they will not come on the same plane, and this is some smaller pedicel, and this is called corymbous, right? So this is called corymbous raceme. So this I basically finished with it, and nectary, I told you, this is nectary. I have nectar glands, and these dots are the nectar glands. Now we are coming to the diagnostic features of this. The cruciform corolla, corolla means they are clawed, and they have claws and wings, limbs which are parallel to each other. Stamens, they are tetradynamous, ovary bilocular due to false septum called rapalum. It becomes parietal placentation. So it, and fruit is here will come silicua and silicula, and the flowers are polypetalous, bimerous or tetramerous, and they're hypogynous. Hypogynous we have done in a lot of detail. So this I already told you. So when we see this again, that is the inflorescence. Raceme we did in case of delphinium, which have indeterminate growth, and they are in case of acropetal form. Whereas cymose clusters, which we did in the ranunculus, they have basically, we will do that is, they are in basipetal. These are two things which should be remembered. Here we have corymbous raceme, the pedicels, they are long, here they are short, but they don't reach to a one plane. But when it will reach to one plane, then it is called corium, and then we have umbel also. So which are we do in the subsequent families, right? So just before leaving, I will tell you the see placentation, right? In case of basically we do ranunculus, we have unilocular with basal ovule. It is called basal placentation. Whereas in case of delphinium, the ovules, they are arranged around the ventral surface, that is the also called this marginal placentation, also called ventral placentation. Whereas here in case of crucifree, the ovules are attached, but because of formation of this rapalum, it changes from unilocular to bilocular, and this placentation is called parietal placentation, right? So this I finishes, and before that I want to tell you the estivation. Estivation which we have right now, because in case of delphinium and ranunculus, we have this one estivation is the imbricate, in which it is down, it is up, it is down, it is up, and it is down, it is up, it is down. So this is called imbricate. In whereas here in case of brassicae, we have the first one, that is the volvate, right? 1, 2, 3, but they are not up down, but they are not even joined also, so they are in same plane, and this type of estivation is called volvate. So this I finishes the brassicae, and subsequently I can move to the other families, very important families like labiatae and Malvaceae, so in next lecture. So first, before that, you have to revise these all conditions, and of these important I already told you are the basic conditions which are important are hypogynous, then we have the epigynous, then we have the perigynous, then we have the placentation, basal, marginal we do, but in subsequent families you have to do the, before I will come tomorrow, we will do the placentation like exile, because exam presentation is in case of Libyeti, whereas in case of Malvesi, it has same exile presentation. So this presentation is common in the next two families we are supposed to do. So anyhow, just revise these families, and I already told you which I did today is with the perspective of competitive exams. So you should be knowing that in Simos cluster, which we have the basibitum, whereas when we do the typical racemes, there is we have the acropetal form of development. So these things are the basically competitive point. So where we have to attempt with the multiple choice questions, right? So stay indoors, stay safe. Bye bye. Take care. Thank you. Morning, everybody. I welcome you all back. Today we are doing the families, and I already told you families are the essential part with respect to the competitive exams, right? So first family we are doing is the Ranunculaceae. Ranunculaceae, we take two flowers, Ranunculus and Delphinium. First I take Ranunculus, which is also called buttercup, and inflorescence is cymose clusters. I will take it later on. And the flowers are ebracteate, bracteate when axillary, ebracteolate, pedicellate, complete, bisexual, hermaphrodite, actinomorphic. Actinomorphic means when flower is cut into two, and that they are both are the equal parts. And then is the hypogynous, pentamerous and thalamus elongated and convex. Now question arises, what are hypogynous? Hypogynous means hypo means blue, gynous means gynecium. If sepals and petals and stamens, they are attached to the receptacle below the ovary. Besides this, it will also put for, in Malvesiae and Anacardiaceae. Thalamus is convex or conical. Androperianth means, androecium, perianth means sepal and petal, is born below the level of ovary. Hence, ovary is superior and other parts are inferior. This is very easy to write in other parts, because then thalamus is not fused with the wall of ovary. So we will do the hypothalamus. See, this is the hypothalamus. Right? See, in this hypothalamus, the ovary is this one, and these all part androperianth, means androecium, sepals and petals, they're below. Hence, then this ovary is superior and other parts are inferior. Right? The other, we have the perigynous and epigynous. Here, you will see the shape of the basically thalamus. Thus, thalamus is convex to conical, right? Whereas in case of, you will see in case of epigynous. Epigynous means, epi means above, gynous means gynecium. If sepals, petals and stamens are attached to the receptacle above the ovary is inferior. See, they are above and ovary is inferior. And other floral plots are automatically superior. The thalamus is, see the shape, flask shaped, right? So this we will read in subsequent families, but I want to explain these here. It is very easy for us to understand later on. Now the third part is the perigynous. Perigynous, the thalamus is disc shaped, you see, disc shaped, saucer-shaped, cup-shaped, right? And androperianth is born around or above the level of ovary. It is basically either the around balanced or above the ovary. Thalamus is free from the ovary wall, you see. Thalamus is free. It is not fused. And periphery of thalamus expanded to form hypanthium. This is question which comes in. This periphery, it will expand to form a hypanthium. Androperianth constituents develop from the common base. So these, they arise from the common base. See, This is base is common. Yeah, common point says it. Base is common. So these are the three conditions we did right now. So now I'm going back to the second part, that is the calyx. It is 5, green when young, polysepalous, imbricate aestivation. And I again write imbricate because star imbricate aestivation is very important. Then odd sepal posterior, right? So I already told you when ovary superior, other thing are inferior. But here we will see 3 to 7 long multicellular hairs, right? Then I come to the corolla, 5 polybetless, alternate sepalous, again imbricate, each wall with a pocket shaped neck tree at the base of the upper surface. Inferior, I already told you, same thing, right? So now we are coming to the C. This is the VS of the flower, and this is calyx, and this is corolla. And in case of calyx, I told you, it is inferior, besides it has a mucilaginous hairs, right? Whereas in case of petals, there is a neck tree at the base, right? So, see, other characters are, we already discussed. Now we are coming to the next part, that is the androecium. Androecium, they are indefinite, polyandrous, spirally arranged on an elongated thalamus, right? Filaments long, anthers basifixed, pythicus, and this is very important, dehiscence longitudinal extrose. When dehiscence occurs, if the spores, they move towards the outside, the out away from the center is called extrose. And then if towards the inwards, towards the center is called introse. Inferior, I know, told you, right? Gynoecium is polycarpellary, right? Apocarpus, spirally arranged on the thalamus. Unilocular, right? Unilocular means one locule, uniovuled, superior, because of the hypogynous conditions, ovary, and placentation basal. This is very important. Style, single, short, and stigma is beaked. Fruit, anterior of achenes, and the seed is endospermic. Ranunculaceae, and we will tell you it is a endospermic. Then this is actinomorphic, and then bisexual, K5, C5, A infinity and G infinity with the superior. So now we are coming back again to the structure of the this. You will see this is thalamus on which first the gynoecium is arranged spirally, and then we have the androecium which is having a basifixed anthers, right? So now there is one thing which came to us is the before we move to the other parts, right? First thing, this is the floral formula. Here, the first thing come to us is, this is first and overlapping this, this overlapping this, then it come down and it above, then down, this is above. And this type of aestivation is called, same with the corolla also, upper, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. So this type of aestivation is called imbricate. See, these are the aestivations we have. The first we I will do in next family, that is Brassicae. Here they are not fused, but they have are in the same plane, and they are called volvate. And whereas second one is, here one is down, one is above, one is down, one is above. This is called twisted, as we twist over back. And then this one, this is down and this is up, this is down, this is up, this is down, this is up.
So this type is called imbricate, and imbricate is two type, that is ascending and descending, that I will take later on. So but right now you will understand that this estivation, which is arrangement of flowers with respect to each other, it is three types. Volvate, I told you, I take the family subsequently after some time, that is Brassicae and Cruciferae, and twisted, and then imbricate. Imbricate we are taking here, right? So after that I move to the floral formula, and endospermic I told you, and then the fruit is Atenia fecans. And one important thing is the placentation, basal placentation. So now question rises, what is placentation? Placentation refers to the arrangement of ovules inside the ovary. Basal placentation, the ovary in which the placenta develops from its base, and single ovule is found attached to the base. This is very important, right? And it is unilocular ovary, I already told you. So in, as I already told you here, it is a unilocular ovary. So from here you will came to know the placentation should be basal and single ovule at the base of the ovary, right? So now we are coming to the see. Here, basal, unilocular ovary, and placenta at the base, right? So this is basal. Here I want to tell you, this is marginal. Here the ovules, they are arranged at the margins. This is the presentation I will do in the next, that is flower, that is delphinium. And these are on the ventral surface, that is why it is also called a ventral placentation. And then next I will do is the in Brassicae, that is parietal. Here parietal is also unilocular, but because of this, there is a formation of here false septum, it becomes parietal, and that false septum is also called rapalum. And then the other I will take today is the exile. It is exile placentation is, we have axile and here it is, and these ovules are arranged around it, axile, right? That is, it is basically multilocular, right? This is unilocular, this is bilocular, and this is multilocular. So these are the basically the placentation I will doing in the subsequent families. So now the next I was taking is the delphinium. Delphinium we also call larkspur, and the family you know Ranunculaceae, and the flowers are bracteate, pedicellate, complete, hermaphrodite, and zygomorphic. So very important, when we cut the plane, the both sides are different. Spurred and hypogynous we did. Spirocyclic means in the cycle form. Then the inflorescence is typical raceme. So earlier we have done is the cymose cluster. I just talked about inflorescence in short a while. Then calyx is 5 free, polysepalous, petaloid, posterior sepal produced into a long and straight spur. This is very important. Posterior sepal is produced into long straight spur in which family? Which flower you can answer, that is delphinium. Imbricate estivation I have done, and by default it is become inferior because ovary comes to be superior because of hypogynous conditions I just told you. See, corolla is 4 gamopetalous, 2 posterior lateral petals produced into a spur and lodged in the spur of calyx. Anterior petal is absent. And stamens and carpels are enclosed in anterolateral petals. Spur contains honey. So this is very important, which we will do. See here. Here we have the first sepals. This is spurred sepal,
right?
Then we have anterior lateral, these are petals, these, and these androecium is enclosed in them, right? See, this is basically the VS, and we have this placentation where I will later on take, that is marginal, right? And these are the spurred sepals and these are the spurred petals, right? So now we are coming to the next, that is androecium. Androecium is indefinite, polyandrous, spirally arranged in five groups of three stamens each, alternating with petals, right? Anthers, basifixed, and dehiscence, longitudinal, extros, same as that of ranunculus, right? And then we are coming to the gynoecium, monocarpellary, superior, unilocular, and where we have the marginal placentation with many ovules, style short but curved, stigma simple and capitate. So the wall of ovary has two type of hairs, long tubular unilocular hairs, unicellular, and a flask shaped hair with swollen base. The fruit is follicle and seed, as in ranunculus, is endospermic, right? The change here is that K is same both cases. See here, there is 5 and apo here is fused 4, but one anterior petal is absent. Androecium is same. So this is same. This is same. Right? So this structure is basically gynoecium. There gynoecium, they are innumerous. They are numerous basically, and they are arranged on the thalamus. Here we have the one gynoecium, that is superior, right, because of the hypogynous condition. This I already told you, imbricate distribution, one margin of each sepal or petal overlaps the next one, and the overlap by preceding one clockwise or anticlockwise. It is in the petals of hibiscus and petal of delphinium and ranunculus we are just doing. So then we are coming to the marginal placentation. The ovules develop in rows near the margins on the placenta. I just told you, formed along the ventral surface. That is what it is called, ventral placentation. It is monocarpellary, unilocular ovary. So this is question will come about the ventral placentation, right? So then we come again back to the flower. So it is very easy. You will see the androecium, they arrange in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3 groups in 5, right? And these basically marginal placentation, and you will see the ovules, they are arranged on the ventral surface or margins. It is also called ventral placentation, right? So this sepals, you will see, up, down, up. This is called imbricate estivation, right? This one is absent. 4 it has, but they are fused, right? So this basically we do, and now we are coming to the inflorescence, which I already told you. So inflorescence here, in case of type of inflorescence, see, the first, it is raceme, right? So raceme inflorescence is basically a type of inflorescence in which it is racemose type. That is typical raceme we are doing right now in case of delphinium. So here it shows the indeterminate growth. And see, In this, the flowers are arranged in acoropetal manner. This is very important. Whereas in ranunculus, I already told you, it is the cymose clusters. Cymose clusters, they are basically like corium, but they their pedicels are not so length. The length should be very, so that they, in case of corium, they arrange, they basically reach at one point. Whereas in case of corium, cymose clusters, they fail to reach. See. Right. But here the arrangement is not acoropetal. Here arrangement is basipetal. Right. So these are basically structure. So this is I am showing you the ranunculus, which shows the cymose clusters with basipetal arrangement, and you will see. Right, whereas in case of ranunculus, the flowers, they are in indeterminate growth, right, but they are in case of acoropetal arrangement, right. So this we finishes the structure of both ranunculus, and now I am coming to the characteristic features, which we did very expandable form. Flowers are hypogonous, we did it. Free sepals and petals, right? They are a diagnostic feature of ranunculaceae, irrespective of the delphinium. Because we are taking the diagnostic feature of families. Sepals usually petaloid, that is undistinguishable, right? So then stamens indefinite and parallel, carpels, pericarpi and apocarpus, fruit aggregate. And here one very important we use in our pickles, and nowadays there are also talks that clungy is effective against coronavirus, but it is not effective, but it will provide, it will increase your immunity level and provide you resistance against the virus. So clungy belongs to this family, ranunculaceae. Right, so I finish this and I will move on again to the other family. So I just revise you the things before moving. So that is the, both are endospermic, and the fruit here is Eteriophakines, and here fruit is follicle. So this is very important. So then before we will go, you will see here the gynoecium, they are arranged on the thalamus. Right? They are spirally arranged on thalamus, unilocular, uniovuled. See, unilocular, uniovuled, right? Placentation basal, ovary ball, tuberculate and not hairy, style single, short, stigma beaked, right? So this we structure we do, and now we are moving to the that is androecium of delphinium. This see the very characteristic feature, marginal presentation, you know, monocarpary, you know, superior, you know, unilocular, you know, then we have the short but curved, see this curved stigma, and simple and capitate, cap is there, right? It is hairy, right? Where last time we said it is not hairy. The wall ovary has, I already told you, there are two hairs, long tubular unicellular hairs or flask shaped hair. So this we finishes, see the formula. This is, I already told you, it does not divide into two planes. It is zygomorphic, bisexual, we know. K5, C4, one petal is absent. A, androecium, is numerous. And G1 is, that is because of hypogynous condition, it is superior. Right? So, take care and stay indoors. Stay safe. I will be back Bye bye.